Good morning, you're with Bloomberg Quint. The GST Council is scheduled to meet today, 11 a.m. to be precise, and the crucial issue of compensation to states will be taken up for discussion. My colleague, Nick Anjori, will join us in just a few minutes to take us through today's agenda. But before that, a quick recap on what's happened on the compensation issue so far. Now, the central government has pegged the compensation cess shortfall for this year at 2.35 lakh crores. Out of this, it has said that 97,000 crore can be attributed to GST implementation. The rest is due to COVID-19 pandemic, which the government is not liable to pay. Now, where will this 97,000 crores come from? States have been given two options. One, borrow this 97,000 crore via a special window by the Reserve Bank of India. Under this option, the principal and interest would be repaid by extending the GST compensation cess beyond 5 years. The second option offered to states is to borrow the entire shortfall of 2.35 lakh crore from the market. But states will have to service the interest on this debt from their own resources. Nick Anjori now joins me to take us through what states have preferred between these two options. Nikunj, what seems to be the option that more number of states are leaning towards?
So states, as of now, there are about 20 states that have picked option one, which includes borrowing 97,000 crore rupees from the special window that would be coordinated by the Ministry of Finance. Now, most of these 20 states are the one ruled by the BJP and its allies like Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Goa, and Gujarat. But the interesting thing here to point out is even when these states, most of them, which are BJP ruled states, have given their preference, there seems to be some inclination towards center raising funds from the market and compensating states. And this has been pointed out by states like Tripura and Goa as well. And Goa has also said that not just the impact of GST, the government should also compensate states for the loss of revenue due to the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic.
Okay, Nikunj, very quickly as a follow-up, when you say that most states have opted for option one, there is sort of a condition that states have expressed along with it, which is that it's the government that should borrow via the special RBI window and not states, just to be clear on that, right?
Right. Tripura and Goa have after they've submitted their preference, they've submitted some suggestions to the government as well, and there seems to be some inclination that the central, even after they've given their preference, they want the central government to come forward and raise the money from the market rather than putting the onus of market borrowing on states, even through this special window that would be coordinated by the finance ministry and the RBI.
All right. Nikunj, there is also some talk of raising the borrowing limit under option one from 97,000 crore to 1.1 lakh crore, as you reported for Bloomberg Quint yesterday. Why is that?
Right. So the central government, when it did its calculation and came up with this 97,000 crore figure, the assumption that were made in GST growth in GST revenues was considered as 10%. But states, when they submitted their preference, they've said that, look, growth in GST revenues has been somewhere near 6 to 7% in the last two fiscal years. And you've calculated, you've assumed a growth rate of 10%, which has led to lower compensation amount, that is 97,000 crore rupees. And now this amount has been increased to 1.1 lakh crore rupees. And this would be discussed in the GST Council's meeting today. So now if all states agree to raise money from this, from the borrowing option one through the special liquidity window, they would end up raising 1.1 lakh crore rupees instead of 97,000 crore rupees decided earlier.
All right. Nikunj, we've talked about the majority of the states who are leaning towards option one with some conditionalities, the potential increase in this borrowing limit. What about the remaining, let's say, nine odd states which don't seem to have preferred either option one or two?
Yeah, so there are about nine states. Most of them are opposition ruled, like Kerala, West Bengal, Punjab, Delhi. There's Jharkhand, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Telangana and Chhattisgarh. These states have not submitted any preferences yet. Their view is they have, since the beginning when these options were given to these states, they have said that the center should borrow and compensate states, and states should, the owners of borrowing to meet for the GST compensation shortfall should not fall upon states, and the center should step forward because it has more resources and wherewithal to borrow money from the market and compensate states. Now, these states would push for a dispute resolution mechanism, which under Article 279A of the Constitution allows for setting up a dispute resolution mechanism if the center or one state or two states among each other have any dispute, and to resolve any of such dispute that may arise due to any reason would be done through this dispute resolution mechanism. So all these nine states collectively do want this dispute resolution mechanism to be invoked and this compensation issue to be resolved under this.
All right. Final question then, Nikunj. Besides the compensation cess issue, what seems to be on the agenda today?
Besides raising the borrowing limit under the option one, which is from 90.1 lakh crore rupees, the two some minute rate changes. There's this one request from the Haryana Drug Manufacturers Association that Ayurvedic hand sanitizers should be the GST rate on these Ayurvedic hand sanitizers should be brought down from 18% to 12%. However, the GST fitment committee, which decides on increase of GST rates, has suggested against any such rate reduction and distinguishing it from alcohol-based hand sanitizers. So the view is that there shouldn't be any rate reduction. However, the final call will be taken by the GST Council, because the case was heard by the Haryana High Court, and the High Court had observed that GST Council should consider this request. So, however, the GST Fitment Committee has suggested against any reduction, the GST Council would still consider this request. Besides this, there's also a request to exempt satellite launch services by ISRO and Antrix Corporation, which are government-owned, from GST. So any services that they apply for launching of satellite services will be exempt from GST. So these are the other two items that are going to be discussed today in the GST Council meeting. Besides that, there's one more request by NPCI to allow use of UPI and IMPS to pay GST by taxpayers. Over to you.
All right, Nikunj, thank you for bringing us those details. Like we said, 11 a.m. is when the GST Council will start its meeting. Stay tuned to Bloomberg Quint on what comes out of the Council's discussion today. Thank you for joining us.